Welcome to Subramani. You have seen so many. We saw that there are 16 points in John Templeton's rules of investment, rules of investing. Now we have come to the last two, and these are very important. And John Templeton may not have been the first person to say it, but these are very important part of the 16 rules. First is an investor who has all the answers, doesn't even understand all the questions. There is absolutely no doubt about this. If you have come into investing and you are learning about investing, you realize that while there is a lot to be learned about, learned about the economy, about the company, about the economy in which you are investing, about the companies in which you are investing, their free cash flows, ROE, RONW, right, all those are definitely important, but far more important is what you are learning about yourself and how are you able to control your own behavior given the circumstances in which you are working, right? So you have been an investor, you have read Lynch, you have read Buffett, you have read Soros, you have question is how do you assimilate all that and apply it, right? So learning is a continuous process. So you learn from the masters, you learn from your own reading of bank balance sheets, you form your likes and dislikes, you form your biases, you form your patience, you know the questions to ask, and that is how you slowly build up the process. Afterwards, after some time, you know that talking to two intelligent people in the market is worth more than 2 days of effort of a dumbhead like myself. I realize that the analyst will obviously know much more than I will ever know about any company which he's tracking 24/7, right? So sometimes you need to do that, but the basis on which you talk to be able to understand that comes from reading of the balance sheet, comes from reading of a book on say investing, a book on behavioral finance, right? All those, all the reading and the assimilating and the rereading and doing some control or delete on your past mistakes, right? And trying to learn from your own past mistakes by writing down very often what you did, what you think. Because when you write down what you think after 6 months or 8 months, when you read it, you realize how wrong you were. That is another learning, because thousands of thoughts cross your head and thousands of actions, but it may translate into only 10 or 12 actions. Now the question is also to find out what happens to all those thousands of ideas. If you had implemented, what would have happened? For example, if you had set up a big legal library in the heart of Mumbai, today, do you think chartered accountants and lawyers would come to you? Answer is no, because today they might be accessing a digital library far more easily than a physical library, right? So when so things change, and when things change, you have to adapt. And when you adapt, it looks like you're contradicting what you thought in the past or what you did in the past, right? So I see project reports which I would have happily jumped up and funded, only to see 5 years later or 6 years later those projects being completely demolished because of change in technology, right? So if you think you have all the answers to in investing questions or to any questions in life, it just means you have not looked hard enough. You do not know how many more questions are there. Number 15 is there is no free lunch. Let me add that there is no free breakfast, there is no free lunch, there is no free dinner. Everything has to be earned in the market. No, if somebody is sitting there to feed you, it is fairly obvious he wants at least 5x of what he spent on your meal. So if somebody has treated you to a 5,000 rupee meal, he is expecting to get at least 25,000 out of you. Normally happens, and we tend to assume some things are free, nothing is free. Your bonus, your dividend, everything has a price. It takes a toll on the share price of the shares that you're holding, right? So everything has a price. Nothing will come free, and there is no reason why somebody should give you something free. Somebody gives you something free and you accept it and you think it is free, you need to rethink. And Sir John Templeton was obviously not the first person who said it. Somebody else must have also said it. And if you invest on your whims and fancies, and because you got something free, you will pay a very huge price for it later on. What is point number 16? John Templeton may or may not have been a religious person, but he says, start with a prayer, it helps. Thank you.